Hello everyone, welcome to this unboxing of a custom Gambit statue based on the appearance of Gambit in the old video game Marvel vs. Capcom. If you watched my Cyclops custom statue unboxing and review, you'll probably recognize the style of the art box here, although the color is way different in order to portray, well, the color scheme that is more natural to Gambit. But as you can see, we have this very cool art box here. This is a quarter scale statue, and yeah, we have Marvel vs. Capcom here. So they did a very good job making a very eye-catching art box. Although the artwork is very simple, it does its job very well, I think. But I'm not gonna stall. I'm just gonna go right ahead, get the styrofoam box out, and remove the top half, and we'll have a look at the statue inside. So let me just set it all up and we'll continue. Alright, so here we have the insides of the styrofoam box. And actually, I think this piece comes, or the box comes, in two layers. So on this layer here, we have the statue and some other parts. And underneath this layer, we probably have the base and maybe some other parts. I haven't checked yet. But let's just start emptying the top half here. And I'm gonna start with this piece right here. So this is piece of plastic. This is some translucent pink kind colored. This is actually his hand. I don't know how well you can see it. So his hand is translucent with this kind of power emitting out from it, and you have this effect going on here. And he's supposed to also hold some cards, I believe. So I'll probably be able to find them inside the box somewhere. So that's a very nice detail, and we are going to see more of this in just a minute, because this is a general theme for this statue. I'm going to put this over here. Let's see now. Then we have... let's start with the heads. So I believe it comes with two different portraits. And this is one of them. So there we go. Let me just check if you can see this. I think it's okay. So this is one of its heads, and the paint application here is very, very solid. It's similar in quality to my Cyclops custom, and it just looks amazing. I think the skin tones, everything looks amazing. So that's one of the heads. Let me just put this somewhere safe. Right there. The other head, I believe, is this one. And here we get a slightly different portrait. The hairstyle is a bit different, and the face is also significantly different. He's got beard on this face here, and he looks very, very cool, I think. It just looks very good. Again, the paint application is very good here. I'm gonna put this over to the other one. And from this point on, I'm not really sure. I think I'm gonna start with this piece here. It's quite heavy. This is obviously his legs. So this piece definitely requires a bit more assembly compared to my Cyclops piece. So this is his legs. He's got them quite spread here. He's got these cool metallic colored boots, his iconic suit here, the blue color with some pink areas here as well. And he's got a magnet in his right foot and a peg in his left foot, which is identical to my Cyclops. I'm gonna put it over here. It's actually quite a heavy piece. So yeah, so this is his. Let me see what's up here. Okay. So this is his torso, but it's not only his torso, it also comes with the jacket on. And that's very cool. So, yeah. So he's got this very nicely detailed jacket. It looks fantastic. And his torso here with his iconic suit. And his left hand on the back here in a cool pose. So yeah. And this is all very, I mean, it's difficult to pinpoint the exact material here, but it's a lighter weight plastic, the cloak here. And this piece, this section up here is actually quite heavy. So it feels very solid and sturdy. But I'm gonna put this somewhere safe. Let me see. I'm not really sure if I missed anything. It's always a bit difficult to tell, but I don't think so. So I'll just remove the second half here and set up the camera. I want to make sure it's sharp for you guys. So just give me 1 second. Alright, so I got rid of the middle section of the styrofoam box, and that reveals the remaining bits and pieces that we have right here. Now in the bottom here we have his staff. And I just realized now, this is made out of metal. So that's not gonna break anytime soon, I think. So it's just this very nice, cool to the touch metallic staff, which is actually very, not very, but quite heavy. So that's very nice, actually. I'm just gonna put it here, I think. And put the plastic thing in back right there. So what else do we have here? We have a hand. Let's see what we got here. So this is a switch out hand for his right hand, which has a very nice finish to it. Actually, it looks very cool. And then, oh, that's cool. We have a card here, a very small piece. I don't know if you can even see it. It's Ace of Spades, and that's what goes into his powered up hand. This one right here. I haven't really figured out exactly how. But it probably fits right on somehow. I'm gonna have to look into that, I think. But that's a very nice little detail. And then I just want to wrap this up nicely so I know where I got it. This is nothing. This is some... Sorry, if you couldn't see anything there. This is details for the base. So here you have more of that pink colored smoke kind of effect, which looks like this. It has a very nice finish. It looks very nice, I think. Let's put it over here. It comes with a magnet as well, by the way. Right, and this leaves us only with one piece, I think, which is the base itself. So let's see, it's a very big base and it's quite heavy. And there we go. So he's standing on this pavement, or whatever this is, which is nicely detailed along the edges here. And there's more of that smoke effect, some slots for the magnets, and I bet this is where his right foot goes. And if we turn it, we can see that it says, I don't know, can you see this? Elite Collector's Gambit. This is 56 out of 80. So that's it. All right. And the next thing that I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna set up the turntable as I usually do, and then I'm gonna see if I can figure out assembling this piece while you watch. So just sit back and relax, and I hope you are enjoying this video so far. I'm just gonna see if I can figure this out now, so give me 1 second. Alright, so I have the base now on top of my turntable here, as you can see, and the very first part we'll attach is this piece here, the smoke effect. It fits on into this socket in the base with a magnet like this, so that's very easy. And the next thing will be the legs here, which fits in with a socket on his left foot, like that. And then it just lines up on his right foot with a magnet inside the foot. Now let me just grab the torso bit and see if I can fit that onto the body, or to the legs here. I have it right here. And it fits in with this one peg right here that goes up into the torso. So I hope I can do this without too much trouble. I think that's it. It seems pretty tight now, at least. So yeah, so far so good. Now I know from experience that these hands here are a bit tricky to fit on, but I'm gonna try and see. I'm just gonna start with the regular hand. So let's see now. There's a small peg, but there's also this magnet inside. Yeah, so if it fits on like that. And the staff here, which is made out of metal, you have to be very careful when attaching it. It doesn't really fit on. It doesn't snap in or click in or anything. So you just kind of have to figure out how to attach it, which can be a bit tricky, I think. And it's not completely symmetrical, which means that there are some details in this end that are not here. And I'm not really sure if there's some kind of logic to that. Maybe it's a weight thing, so they want to add some weight to this end. So maybe that means that you have to have his hand grab this area here. I'm not really sure. Let me try and see if I can do this. And if I can't, I'm just gonna skip ahead, I think. Because you want to be careful not to scratch the paint too much. So it would fit on maybe something like this, and I think that's okay. And then it just kind of rests on the hand. I think this actually looks pretty cool. So we are only missing, well, we are missing the other hand. I'm not gonna mess around with that in this video, I think. If I figure out how to attach the card, which I'm not really 100% sure of right now, then I'll be sure to add that. But for now, let's just forget about these parts here. You can probably get an idea of what it looks like with that hand. And then when he's having this hand on, I imagine that the staff would somehow be fitted on differently. But in my opinion, this looks very good. I really like the way that he's posed with the staff as it is now. So we have these two heads remaining, and let's just put this one on. I really like both heads, actually. I don't really have a clear favorite, but I do really like the bearded portrait though. So let's just keep that for the rest of this video. And that basically sums it all up, guys. This is what he looks like when he's assembled, and I'm just gonna do a 360 now. It's a quarter scale statue, and it's very, very nicely made. On the back here, you can see how his left hand is posed. I wouldn't really know what, how to describe it. It's like a combat move or whatever. I don't believe that the staff is supposed to interact with this hand when he's posed like he is now. And I don't see how it would be able to do so, because it's kind of resting on the cape here. So it's just very secure right now. It doesn't really wiggle any at all. So that looks very nice, I think. But what really steals the show for me is the color combination here. It's a very vivid looking piece, I think, the colors here on the base. The simple base really, but with this very unique smoke effect made of this translucent material is just fantastic, I think. And I just really adore his suit in general, with the blues and the pink colors, the magentas coming together in contrast, and the shading and everything. And finally, of course, his portrait. Both of them really look amazing, I think. The quality of those are just fantastic, I think. So yeah, I'm really, really impressed with the look of this piece. It looks very realistic, I think. And yeah, I'm happy to have this piece based on the Marvel vs. Capcom video game, along with my Cyclops statue. Those two pieces just look fantastic in my collection, I think. Still need to figure out exactly where to put this piece though, but I'm sure that I'll figure something out. But yeah, I guess that kind of wraps it up. I'm gonna do a review as well, of course, and maybe at that time I've figured out exactly what to do with these parts here. But this is, to be honest, I really like the pose as it is right now, with the use of the staff going across on the back here. That looks fantastic, I think. So I'll probably just be swapping out the heads ever so often. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this unboxing, guys. I'm really excited about this piece. I've gotten a lot of statues recently, so yeah, I think the coming time will be a bit more quiet in that regard for me, because I spent a lot of money recently. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this unboxing video, and I'll be sure to follow up with a review of this piece, but also my Ghost Rider statue. Yeah, I'm looking really forward to share my thoughts on these statues with you guys. Thanks a lot for watching. If you have any comments or questions or anything, put them in the section just below. And of course, leave me a like and subscribe to my channel if you liked what you saw here. And of course, also remember to hit that little icon that looks like a bell or whatever, so you get a little notification whenever I post something new on my channel. But yeah, thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys in my next video.